Sir, your screen was now visible for a moment.
Ma'am, Sri Vidya, ma'am. Sir, is this visible now?
Yes, it is visible.
So now I'll change the screen. If it is visible, it is changing in the screen. Whether it's changing or not, sir?
It is changing, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now it is changing, sir. Changing.
Yes. Now, sir? Now also it's changing, na? Sir?
Hello, sir. Changing, sir. It is visible now, sir.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Sir.
Yes, now it's visible, na?
Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We can continue, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
It's changing. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Yes, sorry for the interruption. So, for economic scheduling, before going for economic scheduling, we are in the need of these basic informations like optimal routing as well as the battery state of health, or otherwise we can say the life protection or battery details.
It is in welcome.
Now also.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Now I put slides. That is a
battery slide state of health.
Yes, I have put in slideshow. So only I think it's not visible.
Yeah, don't put slideshow, sir. It is okay with this system.
Okay, ma'am.
Battery state of health. It is now. Okay.
Yes. Now I'll maximize this. Then I'll go with this itself. Yes, now it's visible, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay, thank you. So, before going to rescheduling, we need some data. So, the data is like optimal routing as well as the battery information. So, first we need to do the optimal routing between the starting point to the end point as well as the battery information. Then we know all those things, then we can go for the recharge scheduling. So for recharge scheduling, why this charge scheduling gains importance in electric vehicle alone means, so for fossil fuel vehicles, we can fill the fuel within a minute, so we didn't want to worry about that. But in the electric vehicle, we need to charge the vehicle based on the type of charger available in the parking lot, as well as here the cost, the electric energy cost is may vary from hour to hour. So it may vary, it may high in the peak hours as well as it may very less in the off peak hours. So we need to schedule accordingly, so we need to plan accordingly so that we can able to reduce the overall charging cost as well as the parking station owner, as well as both they may get benefited, both the service provider like charging slot or parking lot owner as well as the consumer. So in electric vehicle, the charge scheduling gains more importance compared to all other things. So while going for the recharge scheduling, so usually if you have a charging point in our home, we didn't want to go for the parking lot. So usually in the urban areas as well as due to the infrastructure, most of them are depending on the parking slot, as well as if you are traveling from one place to another place, the places are too far away from each other, means again we are depending on the parking slot as well as the charging stations. So in charging station also, I said already, based on the various standards in internationally, like Society of Automobile Engineers, SAE, and International Standard Organization and International Electrochemical Commission, as per that we have different kinds of chargers. So we can say level 1, level 2, and level 3, and level 4. So in AC, we have this first level, 1, 2, 3 levels, and then for DC, we have level 4. So based on that, simply we can say the nature of charging is slow, medium, as well as fast charging. Again, the parking slot or charging station owner may charge more for a fast charger as well as the medium charger and slow charger. Based on the type of charger, they may vary the cost. So So we need to plan, we need to go for the scheduling so that only we can able to reduce the overall charging cost, as well as we can able to the charging slot owner can able to gain more profit. So this is about the common charging power ranges available in worldwide, as well as these are all the charging point infrastructure. So nowadays we are following in worldwide. So like in Europe, as per the European Council Electric Power Research Institute, as well as National Renewable Energy Laboratory, like so on. So if you are charging the electric vehicle by using the fast, slow and medium charger, means we need to know the information about the next charging station, or otherwise the charging stations which is available between the routes which we are going to travel. So that information we need to know, then only we can able to plan accordingly. So for that only we are going for the scheduling, optimal scheduling of the electric vehicles in the parking slot, as well as by using any kind of app or otherwise any kind of software, we can recommend the charging station which is available between the two points, or otherwise which available in the route which we are choosing. So the real time status needs more importance. Why? Means there may be a long queue for charging, the waiting time may get increasing in one charging station, the waiting time may be lesser in the next station. So maybe we may have a available power to go up to the next station. Means we need to know in advance, then only we can go. Like that we can able to reduce the cost also. Usually the electric vehicle customers need to go for a smart parking lot to recharge their vehicle during the parking, as well as during the driving. So that is comes under dynamic. So we have some conventional methods like SOC base, as well as first in first come. So here we have different power range, right? So we have some different power range of vehicles, different power range of chargers also available in the charging station. So again, if you are going for one place to another place, and then we need to know the information, means we are again we need to depend the aggregator in the sense, like if you are booking the nowadays we are booking the bus, as well as we are going for some other booking like gas, some other thing, na? So we are going for Redbus or Amazon, like that. So here Amazon, Redbus are nothing but the aggregator. So the person between the service provider as well as the consumer. So we need to depend the aggregator to get the information about the charging station availability, energy cost, whether booking is available or not, as well as the waiting time also. So that we can propose a smart charging infrastructure for the electric vehicle, means the consumer as well as the service provider may get benefited by using this. So as of now, no frameworks or no rules are framed for electric vehicle in India. So maybe in future, while they are regulating this electric vehicle charging as well as electric vehicle charging station, they can incorporate this so that the consumer as well as the parking slot owner may get benefited without the influence of the aggregator. So sometimes the charging station owner may ready to give the concession, may ready to give at very less cost. If the aggregator comes in, so in between the in between the service provider and the consumer, definitely the cost may vary. So the cost may be very high. So that only, so the government need to regulate the the electric vehicle charging stations, as well as the electric vehicle frameworks. So the main objective in the recharge scheduling is to minimize the overall purchase cost, right? To minimize the overall cost about the customer point of view, as well as the parking lot owner point of view, or otherwise we can simply say the service provider point of view also. So usually we can have two kinds of scheduling scheme. We can follow the two kind of scheduling pattern. One is about the static, another one is dynamic. So static in the sense, So if I have a electric vehicle, so I'm using the electric vehicle between my office and my home means, so I can go for the static scheduling scheme. So in static scheduling scheme, the arrival time as well as departure time will be fixed. So if I'm coming to office at 9 a.m. and definitely I'll leave at 4 p.m. only unless otherwise any emergency. So this is comes under static. Otherwise, if I'm going for my home, maybe in my home, in my apartment, the parking slot is available. It'll be the parking lot is operated by any one of the service provider means. So definitely I'll reach the reach home even before 9 p.m. as well as I'll come out after 9 a.m. or 8 a.m. only. So this is a static scheduling scheme. So here the scheduling period, right, the charging period is fixed. So we may say between 6, that is between 9 p.m. to morning 8 a.m. That is a fixed time. So we need to charge the vehicle. So we are giving to the service provider. The service provider need to give the vehicle in the morning tomorrow 8 a.m. at 100% of charge. So that is the objective in the static scheduling scheme. But in the dynamic scheduling scheme, what may happen means, so suppose if I'm traveling from one place to another place, the distance between the two places are too high, means definitely I can't able to come back to my home and then I can't able to charge it with the same parking lot. So I need to charge the vehicle in the way which I'm traveling. So for that, usually we have some conventional method like SOC based, that is if I'm giving the vehicle to the static scheduling scheme means SOC based, the whichever the vehicle is having less less state of charge means they may schedule the vehicle with the fast charger. So if the vehicle is just having more SOC, right, and then so the required power is much lesser means they can schedule with the slow chargers. So that is called as SOC based scheduling. Then next first in first serve scheduling is usually adapted for a dynamic charging scheme. Then we can go for the artificial intelligence method or any soft computing technique for scheduling the both static as well as dynamic charging scheme. Then we can go for the IoT based, otherwise any app or any recommended information for sharing about the charging station, or otherwise for sharing the information between the consumer as well as the service provider. So first we can see the static scheduling scheme. So here I have mentioned the minimization of cost. So the minimization of the cost in the sense both consumer as well as the service provider. So yes, we have different kinds of chargers. So the rate for the different kinds of charger also may vary. The rated power is also may vary with respect to the type of a charger. So the objective is minimization of the charging cost. The charging cost, we can able to find the required power or otherwise the power output of the specific charger in an hour, as well as the cost of the energy, as well as the rental for the the charging station. So we can follow some constraints also. So the constraints is nothing but always we are charging from the minimum SOC to the maximum SOC, as well as the power output power, right? Otherwise the charging power should be within the limit that is between the minimum to maximum of the charging output, charging point output, as well as the maximum allowable charging power is also always should be less than or equal to the charging power demand. So first static scheduling scheme. So in static model, yes, here the arrival time as well as departure time is fixed. So usually this kind of scheduling scheme or otherwise this kind of pattern is followed in home, that is nearby home, that is apartments as well as in office and all. So here the computation process is much easy. So here we can go for the SOC based method. See here, so here the charging period, so here this time is fixed. So we can, the objective of the service provider or parking lot owner or charging station owner is to charge all the vehicles, whatever the vehicle is available at the time of starting. So they need to schedule, they need to charge all the vehicle within this time period at minimum cost. That is the main task, that is the main objective of the service provider or the charging point owner. So for that, we can go for the SOC-based priority algorithm. So this is one of the conventional method. So here, how we are following means, first, we are getting the information from the vehicle whenever it's arriving. Say example, all the vehicles may arrive. So in the scheduling scheme, yes, the timing, charging time is fixed. So no other vehicle will come in between. So all the vehicle may arrive at exact time, on or before the time, as well as it may leave on or after some time. Say example, if you are taking night 9 p.m. to morning 8 p.m. That is the time period. So when it's arrived, so the charging, that is charging point owner or otherwise the parking lot service provider may check the vehicle at the time of 8 or 9 p.m. whatever the vehicles available in the parking station. So they may they may get all those details, like what is the available SOC, what is the rated capacity, what is the required power for each and every vehicle. Once they have received all those information from all the vehicles, then they can go for the vehicle arrangement based on the SOC. So once SOC known, rated required power is known, they can arrange the vehicle from ascending order or descending order. Then they know what are the types of charger available and what are the number of chargers available. Based on that, they can go for the scheduling. So while going, they'll take care of the energy cost also, right? So here they are checking the chargers are in ideal mode, whether it's available or not. If it's available, then they can go for the charging. Then they may allocate all the vehicles. Say example, if 20 vehicles are available, only five chargers only in ideal case means. So first they may put the five chargers with the maximum required power vehicles. Then the remaining vehicles, right? For the remaining vehicles, they may update the waiting time. So here they may simply display the cost as per the time of charging, or otherwise for this scheduling scheme, usually the service provider may charge from the consumer at constant cost basis, at constant price. So and then they may make the profit. So in static scheduling scheme, so for this static scheduling scheme, this is the conventional technique which we are using. So here we are scheduling the vehicle as per the state of charge, either in ascending order or descending order. But here for this case also, we can use some artificial intelligence or soft computing technique to get the scheduling if the number of vehicles are more compared to the number of chargers, so that we can able to get at less cost or otherwise the good scheduling. So by doing so, by implementing this scheme, we can able to save some amount of cost for the consumer as well as for the service provider. How the consumer may save the cost means, so here there may be so many service providers nearby, so there may be a healthy competition between the service providers, so like a deregulated electricity market, so they can able to provide the service which is less cost compared to the nearby. So the consumer also may get benefited, the service provider is also may get benefited. But what is the disadvantage, what is the difficulty we are facing in this scheme means, but in realistic world, definitely we can't able to say the exact arrival as well as departure time of the EV, even though if they are working in the office or otherwise parking lot is situated nearby the home also, right? So the prediction of the arrival as well as departure of the electric vehicle is much difficult to predict. So that only we are going for the dynamic charging scheme. So in the dynamic charging scheme, we are going to consider the vehicle arrival and departure time is not fixed. So the vehicle can able to arrive at any time, as well as the customer or otherwise the vehicle owner can decide the departure time also. So the departure time as well as arrival time may vary in this dynamic charging scheme. So here what we are doing means, so here we are doing the scheduling with respect to the current time slot. So here the time slot may have taken as for every hour, for every hour in the sense 60 minutes. So for every hour, the parking lot owner or the charging station owner may take the data, whatever the vehicles are available for charging, what are the vehicles are charging, already in the charging, as well as what are the vehicles are waiting. Based on that, they can able to give the waiting time for the upcoming upcoming electric vehicle, as well as the electricity price, as well as even it's a microgrid or smart grid also, means they can able to give at least cost compared to the another service provider. So here also the objective function is minimization of the overall cost in the point of service provider, as well as the the consumer, right? So here this is nothing but it shows the availability of the charging, whether if it's this is an integer, if it's zero means we can take for mathematically while modeling it. So we need to take like this. If it's zero means the vehicle is not charging, if it's one means the vehicle is charging, like that. So here conventional method, again we can go for the SOC method, but SOC based method is not suited for this dynamic charging. Why it's not suited means, so every time we can't able to find the discharge SOC based in ascending order or descending order. So here for that only we are going for the arrival time based priority algorithm, or otherwise it's also called as, simply we can say in our words, we can say this is the first in, first out, first serve. Okay, so this is the conventional technique. So here, say example, at 10 a.m. so whatever the vehicles are available, whatever the vehicles coming first, we can give first priority to them. And then irrespective of the SOC, irrespective of the rated power required, we can allot the vehicle, we can allot the vehicle for charging in this dynamic charge scheduling scheme. This is the conventional technique. So for this case, we can go for the some optimization techniques or artificial intelligence, so that we can able to get much more better results compared to the conventional thing. So here, what are the things we need to optimize means, so here we need to optimize the vehicle, right? Which vehicle is allotted for the charging station, at what time, which type of charger, that and all we can optimize here. So by optimizing it, we can able to get minimum cost. Minimum cost as point of the service provider, as well as the consumer. So in both the cases, either in static scheduling scheme as well as in dynamic scheduling scheme also, we can go for the artificial intelligence or optimization technique or soft computing technique, any technique, so that we can able to minimize the overall cost. We can able to achieve our objective. So the cost may be the objective may be good compared to the conventional method. So in both the conventional method, SOC based as well as arrival time based priority method also used in static as well as dynamic charge scheduling scheme. So in this method also, in this method, that dynamic charge scheduling method, so the overall purchase cost may be calculated with two kind of vehicles. One is electric vehicle with appointment, another one is electric vehicle without appointment. Say we can able to, if in the dynamic charging scheme we can book our charging slot well in ahead. Say example, if I'm going to travel from one place to another place, so it's known well ahead means, so I know very well, so my vehicle battery health and all, I know that. So once I know that means, I know how much distance it may go. So So based on that, I can able to book the charging slot well and earlier. So by doing so, the parking slot owner may schedule the charging points, may schedule the charges well and ahead. So that only they can able to, again, they can able to minimize the overall cost. So for that, the electricity cost or otherwise, the charging cost for the vehicle with appointment and without appointment may gets vary. So in both the cases, the cost is minimized by using a conventional technique as well as the optimized optimization technique. So compared to conventional technique, definitely the optimization technique may give good results. Why it may give good results? So in conventional technique, simply we may go in order. Say example, in a SOC based method, we may go first, what is the lowest SOC vehicle? First we may schedule that vehicle. Then after that, after the first, which has lower value, lower SOC value, like that we can schedule. But in the optimization technique, so comparatively they compare whether this one or this one, like that in random manner if you are doing means. So in optimization technique, first of all we can generate the random population, then we are updating it with number of iterations, with number of control parameters, so that we can able to get good results compared to conventional methods. So again, so here the electricity cost is increased compared to the previous one. Why it's increased compared to the previous one? Previous one in the sense static scheme. So here we are charging the vehicle without an appointment or otherwise without the, yes, without the prior appointment, as well as here we are giving the charging time. The charging time is may limited in the dynamic charging scheme, so that here we need to book the charging slot in the charging station. That is a main important thing. So for that only we are going for the charging station booking by using the aggregator. Aggregator is nothing but it's a third party, or otherwise if we have the government has given any platform, like now and all we are purchasing energy, purchasing electric energy by using the EX and some defined platform, like so on. If we have a defined platform, we can go for the charging station booking with the defined platform. So up to now we got some ideas about the static and dynamic charging scheduling. So even in dynamic charging scheduling, we have some difficulties. How we can book, how we can get to know the information about the forthcoming charging station, right? So maybe for this, definitely we are in the need of GPS. So even then, if you are getting from the GPS, in GPS sometimes it may show the next fuel station is available in left side, but due to some unavoidable situations, the fuel station maybe gets closed or otherwise the it's permanently closed or temporary closed means, so we can't able to do anything at that time. So that only we are going for this charging station recommendation. So here the consumer as well as the vehicle manufacturing industry, so they are changing from they are implementing more and more novelty in the electric vehicle generation, so that if they are implementing this kind of application with that vehicles, as well as the government also introduced about the common platform to book the electric vehicle charging station means, so we can give suggestion like this thing. Okay, so here we can create a database. So we can go for the IoT. So here we can create a database, so that database may connect with all the charging stations as well as all the vehicles through the any interface, right? So first of all, we need to evaluate the battery. So the evaluation of the battery, usually it may be in three kind of things. One is about the first, we want to evaluate the battery means, so we can evaluate the battery in in the point of electrochemical as well as in the adaptive model or otherwise in the electrical point of view. So in first method, exact measurement can be done. So exact measurement of SOC can be done, but that is somewhat difficult. That is electrochemical method. So second, that is adaptive method. So if the equivalent model is exact, then we may get the exact results. If it's not equal, the equivalent model is not too much accuracy, we may not get the exact SOC or otherwise exact required power as available power also. Then third is about the that we know SOC we can measure by using the Coulomb counting method or ampere hour method or open circuit method, circuit voltage method, like so on. So with respect to the parameters which is available, which is measurable in the vehicle, that is charging current, discharging current, open circuit voltage, resistance, all those things. So we have created a small model like by using a Coulomb counting method for the charge, that is a charging station recommendation. So Coulomb counting method, it's also called as ampere, that is AH method, that is the ampere hour current integration method. So this is less complicated compared to all other electrochemical as well as adaptive kind of methods. So here we can able to calculate the available power by using the discharge current as well as the voltage. So here the required voltage, that is required SOC, the required SOC, or otherwise simply we can say the required power, right? The required power can be calculated easily based on the available SOC which is available in the battery. So the Coulomb counting method, so here for a prototype, we have used the LTC4150 Coulomb counter for counting it. So this is the range of this is only about 9 volt, right? So here why we are using Coulomb counting or AH method means it has very less complexity as well as due to its simplicity also we are going with this. So by using this, we can able to get the battery SOC simply by calculating the Coulomb or otherwise by calculating the current output, we can able to get it. So if you are going for any kind of application, IoT application, for charging station recommendation means, so we need, again, we need these three parameters. One is about, we need to test the SOC, right? We need to test the battery SOC, then only we can able to know what is the available power of the vehicle as well as what is the power need to charge as well as how much distance it may travel with this with the available power. Then charging station selection algorithm. So this charging station selection algorithm is nothing but our recharge scheduling scheme. Either it may be a static, so this may be helpful only in dynamic. So thus charging scheduling, there is charging station selection algorithm is nothing but recharge scheduling. This may be done by any artificial intelligence or otherwise any soft computing technique. Once we have did the optimization, that is optimal scheduling, then we can go for the integrated database for proposed application, that is IoT application. So first we can able to test the SOC. So as I have already mentioned, so here we are using LTC Coulomb counter. So the rating of the LTC Coulomb counter is about 9 volt 300 mAh, and then here Arduino USB 8266 is used as a controller, then a 9 volt DC motor. So with that, lithium ion battery can deliver for 60 minutes, about 60 minutes it may deliver 300 milliamps. So the motor load, the small motor has been taken. The motor load is about 70 mAh. So with the new battery, with the full capacity of the battery, the motor can run up to 4.28 hours. So here the charging cost may be calculated by using the energy cost as well as the rated power of the specific hour. So this is the when we are starting the motor. So the Coulomb counter, it starts counting it. So here we have given 30 seconds time period. So for every 30 seconds it's counting the it's calculating the available power. See, it's starting from 290, it is 300 mAh, so it's starting from 299. It's getting reduced, so we can fix the minimum minimum level. So once it's reached the minimum level, it may give the warning to the consumer or driver, so that they can go for the booking, or otherwise they can search for the nearby charging station through this IoT applications. So here how the SOC can be measured means, so first you need to initialize the Coulomb counter as well as the Arduino. Then we need to make the communication between the system and Arduino, and then we need to connect with the load and battery. So if you are giving supply, the motor can run. If it's running, the Coulomb counter may sense the available power for every 30 seconds, and then it will store the data through this Arduino to the system, and then it may display the results. So we can fix the here we can fix the minimum SOC level. Once the minimum SOC level it's reached, then we can go for the finding of charging station allocation also. So here charging station selection algorithm. So here again the charging station selection based on the geographical location. So this geographical location may be fetched with the application through this application program interface. So this API protocol, which has two programs which communicate each other. So here the application program interface can be accessed through the HTTP protocol. So here the charging station as well as electrical vehicle data both should be fetched in the online IoT application. Then say again we need to calculate the battery drain rate, that is nothing but the available SOC, by using the Coulomb counter. Once we need we know the battery drain rate means, we can able to determine the SOC. Once we know the SOC, then we can able to find the available SOC of the battery. So with the available SOC of the battery, we can able to calculate how much distance is going to travel, or otherwise this how much distance the battery is going to get empty. That distance we can able to find. Once we have found, or otherwise once we have estimated the distance to empty, then we can drive up to the maximum limit. Within that we need to find the charging station. So for that we can go for the availability index. So availability index means, yes, for in mathematically, if you want to in mathematical formulation, we need to manipulate this means. So we can say if it's zero means we can go for available, one means waiting number, one, two, like that. So with that this distance to empty and artificial availability index, we can go for the optimization. Then we can get the what are the charging station available in ascending order from the nearby to the end of the distance. So with that we can go for the booking option. So this is the overall flowchart for charging reservation using IoT application. So here we have a vehicle battery, then we are when it's running, we can go for the SOC estimation through this Coulomb counter, and then this can be stored in the synchronized SQL, cloud SQL. So this can be given to optimal EV application. So here the data can be processed, that discharge rate of battery, then it can be calculated the remaining charge estimation. At the same time, this is about the consumer side, at the same time the information will be received from the charging station also. If both informations are received, means we can go for the optimization. With the optimization, that is optimization is nothing but the recharge scheduling. The recharge scheduling can be done by any conventional method or any soft computing technique. Either it will be a first in come first come, or otherwise available based priority scheduling method, or otherwise any soft computing technique. So with that we can able to give the option, we can able to display whatever the available charging stations nearby. So this is the this is the data we have taken. So say example, we have taken from Chennai to Chengalpet. So we have considered all the petrol pumps as a charging station. So with that, here we have not created the vehicle. Simply we have given the information to the application. So here we have given the location, origin location, current location, as well as the destination location, the battery capacity, the mileage, vehicle mileage available. All these information, if you have installed a device in an electric vehicle itself, means all those informations will be fetched by the from the vehicle itself. So once we have given this, then again, suppose if you are starting from Tambaram to Pondicherry, if you are traveling, and then the current location is Potheri, means we know the battery capacity, vehicle mileage, as well as the battery available capacity. So with that, we can, with these informations, it can be calculate how much distance, that is, or otherwise simply we can say how much distance it may, the battery may get drained, as well as how much distance is our destination, what is the traveling time. All those things will be calculated. Once it's calculated, then we can go for the it may gives the go for the scheduling, and it may gives the recommendation of the charging station with distance, as well as name, as well as here we can go for one optimization score. So here, why we have introduced this optimization score somewhere. So example, if I'm traveling from one place to another place, maybe that is not much more important work. So I'm ready to wait for more time, right? I'm ready to wait for more time. So the money is not, the money is the main concern for me. So I need to charge my vehicle at very less cost. At very less cost means, so I can go for this optimization score. This optimization score may include the energy cost, that is electric energy cost, the time for charging, as well as and then third is about the waiting time. So all these three can be clubbed together. So we can change the optimization score. Only I need to go for the economic, right? I need to charge my vehicle economic because my work is not too much important. So I can ready to wait more time for charging, only for charging, not for waiting. Means I can give only, say, in the optimization score, I need to give the option only for economical. For the fast charging option, I didn't want to choose, as well as I need to give for the waiting time. Waiting time also, I'm not ready to wait for more time, means I need to give both option or disable, means. So the optimization score may gives based on the availability of the charging stations. So here the proposed IoT scheme, which will gives the more security, in which point it we can say it's more security, means simply if you are going for some other aggregators, definitely the aggregator may use our data. So the government or otherwise under the regulation itself, we have the application or otherwise IoT app like this, means. So our data will be more secure, as well as here we didn't want to share the information to any other aggregator, as well as we didn't want to rush to any other charging station, as well as we didn't want to pay extra cost to any other aggregator. Directly we can pay to the service provider or a charging station owner directly, so that we can able to reduce the overall cost, as well as we can able to reduce the time also. So here we have developed the small application. So the IP address for the application, by considering with the various factors like convenience, variation of electricity prices. So this has been developed. So then here, finally, this scheduling scheme. So here we can go for static as well as the dynamic scheduling scheme for recharging the electric vehicle. So in both the scheduling scheme, our objective is to minimize the overall cost of the service provider, as well as the electric vehicle electric vehicle owner, that is nothing but the consumer. So that we can able to reduce the overall electricity cost, we can reduce the emission. Again, if they are using the their own cogeneration plant, the charging station owner, they may have their own cogeneration plant, or otherwise they may have their own distributed energy resources, means definitely they can able to give at less cost comparatively to another charging station. So it may produce the healthy competition among the service provider, so obviously the consumer may get benefited. So if you are doing the scheduling, that is charge scheduling by using the artificial intelligence, or otherwise by using a conventional technique also, we may get benefited. So the solution which is proposed by the optimization technique as well as the conventional technique, which will saves the cost of the both consumer as well as the service provider, as well as the peak demand is also gets reduced. So, but in realistically, the dynamic scenario is only more realistic, and then in dynamic scenario only we need to book the vehicle in advance. So then only they can able to go for the exact scheduling. So again, they can able to use their utilities, they can able to use their whatever there's available options. So usually we can use the electric vehicle in future, like reliability, based on the reliability, as well as we can use for you can use this as a one of the source in our home and all. So vehicle to vehicle, so in future in vehicle to vehicle as well as vehicle to grid charging also we can incorporate. As well as here in our work, we have in scheduling, we have taken 100% of charging from SOC, minimum SOC. If you are reaching the charging station, we are charging from minimum to maximum. So say the cost is more in one of the charging station, means so our battery is going to drain fully, means so we can charge a little in the first charging station, then we can book the another charging station at least cost. If you have some other charging station is available at least cost, means we can go to the another charging station so that again the charge, that is the overall cost, is gets reduced. So and then we can consider some other factors also, like penalty. So if the consumer has booked a slot and then they have not visited the place for charging, means definitely if they have not cancelled it also, they can go for the penalty. So why they need to charge penalty, means because of that they may lose some other consumer. So the consumer may choose some other thing, so that the parking lot profit can be maximized. So the optimal routing, so when we are doing optimal routing, we can consider the transportation congestion as well as the road condition, vehicle condition, all those things we can consider. Yes, thank you. Any other? This is about the overall view. I have not discussed about any method especially. So any artificial intelligence or soft computing method especially for this problem. So if you have any queries, please welcome. If you don't have any question, I'll share my mail ID. So if you have any information regarding in this, please call me or feel free to mail me. So I'll ready to share my thoughts with you.
Thank you very much, Vishwa sir.
Yes, ma'am. Welcome, ma'am. Ma'am, I'll share my PPT as well as I'll share my mail ID also. Please share to the participants if they have any clarification, anything. I'll share my views now.
Thank you, sir.
Attitude is the
memory. Yes, ma'am. Yeah, carry on.
Yes, please. I'm not getting anything.
Mostly carry on.
Thank you, sir, for your informative speech. Gratitude is the memory of the heart. Gratitude makes sense of our past, which brings a peace for today and creates a vision for tomorrow. Now, I would like to invite Dr. S. Mahendran, Associate Professor, Department of Electrical and Electronic Engineering, K.S. Rangaswamy College of Technology, to deliver the word of thanks.
Good morning, everyone. Am I audible?
Sir, you are audible.
Good morning, everyone. I am Dr. S. Mahendran, and I am here to propose vote of thanks for the Day 5, Session 1, Atal Academy-sponsored FTP on challenges and opportunities in execution of artificial intelligence for electric vehicle design. On behalf of Department of EEE, K.S. Rangaswamy College of Technology, and my own behalf, I would like to thank our today's subject expert, Dr. K. Selvakumar, Assistant Professor, EEE, SRM Institute of Science and Technology, Chennai, for readily accepting our invitation and gave deep insight in the topic of optimal scheduling of electric vehicles in a parking lot and charging station recommendations. Through the sessions, our attendees gained more knowledge, and I assure that they will use this in their research work. I thank you very much for your wonderful session, sir. I also thank all our attendees for their interest and patience listening throughout the session. Thank you all. Thank you very much for the opportunity given to me. Thank you all. Over to MOC.
Thank you, sir. Finally, it's a pleasure to thank everyone for gracing this event. Feedback link will be shared through WhatsApp group. The next session will start by 11:30 a.m. Participants are requested to join the session 5 minutes earlier. Thank you all.
Participants, we have an announcement. I have loaded the PPTs in the file, Teams file. You can download it from the Teams file. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Srividya madam, stop pannidalaangala?
Yes, sir. We can stop, sir.